Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Create and Process. In this tutorial, we're going to see the extended version of the Transform Text Effect tutorial using Adobe Illustrator. I'll be creating all the text individually, and this is the extended version. These are the text effects which I have left out in our main tutorial. In the previous video, we have created a nice pattern and convert that into art brush. And after that, we have applied that to our stroke. And once it's created the text, we have applied transform option where we have adjusted the position and the number of copies, and that way we got this effect. So let's begin with our designing process. So here it is. We want a little bit of curvy and a little bit of soft version of text. These are some interesting text effects. We can use it to create these designs. And first of all, I'll just try to create this R shape. So instead of using text, what I can do is I can just draw it out. So I'm going to use a rectangle tool and draw out a rectangle, something like this. And selecting these two points, just make this into round. Yes, something like that. And using the Shear tool, I just cut this part and delete this. And there we go. I'll just increase the stroke thickness. Okay, around this much, fine. Just to see that. And I'll create one more line. Okay, from here to here. And one line around, probably. Yep. Now let's apply the brush. So in our main tutorial, we have applied the art brushes, created the art brushes over here. So these are the art brushes. And it was very simple to create. The only thing you have to do is create a rectangle, fill this up with black color, right? Again, create one more, snap it to edge. Okay. Fill this up with white color. Create a duplicate, make sure you leave a gap in between, right? And create one more duplicate around this much. Command D, D, D to duplicate, Command D or Control D. Then over here and hard brush and click OK. Give it a name. Here, set the direction, okay, up and down, that's fine. And then click OK. Okay, that's how I have created that art brush. And now let's use that art brush and keep it around this much. This one, keep it around this much. I want to remove these intersections. So I'm gonna just draw a shape. Just make sure you're following the curve path of this design. So I'll just make a curve. One point there, and there. There, there, there. Fill this up with any color. And let's reduce the opacity a little bit. Okay, and let's adjust these anchor points. I'll just extend the handle. Now I'll trim it. So selecting this shape and this shape. Before we go there, there's one more step I want to do. Let's make this something like this. It has to be nicely curved. So I'm going to use the auto pen tool and anchor point tool. Click this and just bring this up something like this. Yes, click that and make it like that. This one. We'll make it around like this, something like this. Let's place it close to our design, as close as this much. Okay, this one will make it a little bit down. Okay, and make sure they are aligned properly around this much. Yep. In the same way, I'll just select these points and drag it down. Yep. We'll do some adjustments with the alignment. So selecting these, right, I'll go to art brush and go to this option. And let's try to align it. Yes, something like this. Alignment a little bit. I think this is good. Maybe I'll just extend this a little bit. Select these and just extend it around till here. And adjust the curve accordingly. Settings. So I'll just select these curves and expand them. Object expand. This will convert them into object. Right now, this region is left out. Just make sure your shape is completely filled. Now select this, trim, delete this, and there we go. I want to use the rectangle tool, so select that. Let's draw out a rectangle. Very easy. Select this and trim it. Ungroup it. Delete it. Let's group this. Command G. Now overall, select everything, group this up, Control G, right? And we'll go to Effect, Transform, right? And let's apply it. So first of all, I'll just increase the vertical length one by one, and let's increase the number of copies. Yep, around, let's say 50. And let's preview the value. So you can set this to 3, and this one to 5. And there we go. We got that nice, interesting text effect there. So it looks different, but it's giving you that nice look, design look. There we go. To create a PE, I'll just go in there, select these, and create out a duplicate. And there we got a PE. Interesting, right? Let's just create a straight line, fill this up with some stroke color. With a pen tool now, escape, okay, then select this and draw one line around here, and there we go. Fill this up with some stroke colors, increase the stroke thickness, right? And let's work with it. We need one more line over here. Just click and drag until this much, select this point, extend to around this much, yes. And we'll make it a curve. So using the anchor point tool, just click and drag and create a curve, something like this. This one, break it and just give a cut. See, cut there. And this one, using the anchor point tool, just see, okay, something like that, right? Let's extend it around this much, the bottom one and this one. So we want this to be curve around here as well. So selecting this, like this point, and make it curve. Very simple. Now let's apply. So like these, go to art brush and apply the effect, or maybe let's choose a different one, black one, right? And reduce the size around, yep, okay. And let's trim this part a little bit. So I'm gonna just keep it around this much, okay. And let's trim this part. So we can use the pen tool, follow along the edge of this, click and drag, create a shape covering the whole region, fill this up with some solid color, right? Now selecting that and this one, we have to convert this into object. So we'll go to object, expand appearance, then selecting this, go to pathfinder and just trim it out and group this, or maybe double click inside, go there, delete this and come out, and there we go. Select everything and go to effect, transform 0.3 and 0.5, and number of copies around 50. Let's see. There we go. Click OK. And here it is. Arrange this to back. Command or control press. Click open square bracket. This one will move it a little bit. This side and that side. And that's how we got this number. If you want to create 5 using the number text, you can just, let's say, I'll just type out 5 with this 5, okay. Scale up the size around this much. I'll just expand this object, expand. I'll fill this up with stroke color, seize the tool, cut, and then cut. Okay, you can delete this. Die selection tool, select this point and delete it out, come out, and there we go. Let's increase the size a little bit, just move it up this part, move this side, and there we go. We got our text. Selecting this art brush, apply it, select the anchor point and extend it, reduce the size a little bit, okay. Go over here and reduce the size. Yep, I think this fits, and you can just customize this. Die selection tool, you can just make a little bit of tilt effect somewhere on there, and I think overall that looks good. Hold on, directly go to effect, transform, just to see the effect, 50, 0.3, 0.5. There we go. Increase this to around 0.7 and 0.4. See the effect. So if you give a little bit of angle over here, just at 3, you can see that it gives you a very high point. So we'll keep it at 0.1. Let's see the effect. Little bit of angle, 0.5. Let's see the effect. Yes, so 1. I think this looks good. I'll keep it this way. And there we go. We got that interesting look for our number 5. you are interested to create J, you can see we got that nice interesting look over there. Let's try to create that. It's very simple. Pen tool, click, 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 and click. Or maybe you can directly use J, alphabet J. So I'll just bring that. Okay, type J. Let's convert this into a little bit italic. So I'll go over here and italic, object, expand, apply stroke, C for scissor, give a cut, then cut, delete that. There we go, selecting this, apply the stroke, color, and let's adjust the thickness a little bit. Let's apply effect, transform, 50, copies, and 1 by 1, too huge, or maybe you love it, you can do it, but we'll keep it around 0.7 and down 0.6. Let's see. Yes, it looks good. Click OK and looking interesting, but we want to see black and white, where this region should be black and this should be white. So let's see this. Selecting this, I'll go over here and just flip it over there. Okay, this one is good. Click OK. And we'll reduce the length a little bit by going to transform, right? And let's increase the number of copies to just to avoid this dotted line. You can increase this to 70 copies. And let's reduce this to 3 by 5. And there we go. We got that interesting looking text there. Very simple, very easy to create. And in our main tutorial, we have seen how to create these text, X and T, right, and T. So these are some of the experiment I tried to create using the transform rotate tool. So you can see we have created this, some kind of look, this, some experimentation. These are some of the versions you can create. And that's how you can create some amazing text effects using this technique. It's very simple, very easy. If you are interested on more amazing text effect tutorials, I have created a series on this. You can find the link in the description. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe this channel. Thank you.